Here you can see a tree. This looks very high poly count, but it's just 4000. And I used my low poly tree generator for that. So here I got a bunch of options, and we'll go through each and every one of them. We start with these and try to make the UI as intuitive as possible. You can turn the display off, and then you basically only see the tree itself, the branches. And turn it back on. You can scale the leaves from center, and you can scale from point, which doesn't look all the different, but when you use expand and then you scale from point, then it makes all the difference. You can rotate. Can change the texture. You can color correct the texture. And then we go to the branches. You can turn the branches off. And then you can basically make a bush from the tree, or you can just view what your leaves look like. You can also turn it to skeleton, which will show the tree structure, but it will make everything very smooth for performance wise. So as you probably noticed, it's a bit laggy when you change parameters over here, but when you change it to skeleton, there's no problem whatsoever. The generations is basically how old the tree is. The younger it is, the less branches, the older it is, more branches, more leaves. Pretty explanatory. The trunk height. The thickness, which you can see in skeleton, but when you turn it on. Let's turn off the leaves just so you can see it more clearly. You can see the thickness changes. Let's put the leaves back on. Then we have an angle top. Oh, let's put it back to skeleton because that's better for performance wise. Then we have gravity, and you can see how drastically you can change the tree. You have a random seed value. You have a step size scale, which is basically when you have generations at 7, but the step size is very low, then the scale of everything is very low. And all controls on this tree are animatable, so you have very fine control, as you can see. You can bend the trunk. You have a thickness scale. I'll show that by turning up the leaves. You can have very fine branches over here. I'll turn the leaves back on. What else do we have over here? Let's put it back to skeleton there. You got a bend height. So that's basically where you bend. We got a rotate Y, which is very convenient. And we got a random scale. Which scales all branches randomly. Now, to make it more interesting without changing every parameter by hand and you just want something, you can randomize everything. All parameters are randomized. The leaf color option I have turned off by default, as you will get different colors for the leaves, and maybe you just want your default color like green leaves. When you change it, you can see how easy it is to just get a random tree. And it's all in real time, it's really fast. I have optimized a lot. Now I want to show the colors in the leaves as well. What else do we have? The poly optimization panel over here, which can be reached from either leaves or branches, so you don't have to switch back the whole time. When it's on, you will get a limit of the poly count you enter. And when you change the value, I had it when you change the value that it would be optimized immediately, but that would be very laggy. So now I built in a safety. When you change any slider, it turns back off. So it's a safety switch. You have to turn it back on when you want to export it. Yeah, you can enter like a value. I have 4,000 here, but I got a tree over here. That's just 500 bodies, and it still looks good. And then you can export it, like HTTP, I get tree.obj, for instance. You can accept, hit save, and you're done. The tree is saved.